Play City family, what is up? It is Bobby coming at you at my second home, the grocery store. I'm doing some shopping here and I'm seeing some new exciting products. So I wanted to flip on the old iPhone and do a video called Even More Healthy Junk Food, because I think a few weeks ago I did a video called Healthy Junk Food, but I see new and exciting stuff that people want to eat, and they're better for you options with healthier ingredients. Because I'm never going to tell you not to eat your pizza, not to eat your chocolate chip cookies and your brownies. I'm going to tell you to eat the better for you option with best in class ingredients. So that's what we're going to do. Let's walk around, show you some healthy junk food, how to read the ingredients and tell you what to put in your body, and hey, what you might want to avoid. Okay, less talking, more shopping. This is why I love coming to the grocery store so much. You never know what you're gonna find. We've entered the cookies and crackers aisle. So much junk food here, but there's new items I've never seen before. High-key cookies, keto diabetic-friendly cookies, now at Whole Foods, what? And this, I've heard rumors of this, Simple Mills. Look at this, chocolate brownie seed thins and honey cinnamon. Simple Mills. Almost all the products are Bobby approved, Chicago based. What up with that? Look at the ingredients though. Seed, nut, and flour blend. Watermelon seed flour, what? That's like Kramer on Seinfeld when he saw the cinnamon raisin bagel. I thought I'd never live to see the day. Watermelon seed flour, cashew flour, sunflower seeds, and flax. Super food alert. Sweetened with coconut sugar. Binder's tapioca. No natural flavors, real vanilla, right? Not keto, but it is paleo. Holy cow, that's so cool. And the honey cinnamon, I used to have honey cinnamon graham crackers when I was younger. This is way better. $4.99 a box, not super cheap. Maybe Costco will pick it up like they do their crackers. That is cool beans. And then some people see this and they've been scanning with the Bobby approved app, which I'll tell you about in a second. It's Susie's. They make like grain-free bagels and grain-free chocolate chip cookies. They just don't use the best oils here. See, organic palm shortening oil with a star. The star means they do palm done right. It's organic, deforestation free. Rest of the ingredients are actually epic. See, even if palm is done right and you don't deforest, which is a huge problem in the palm industry, it's still a highly processed oil. So you'd rather see like a coconut oil like they do in the Simple Mills. So this is unfortunately not Bobby approved. Go to the App Store, Google Play or Apple iTunes, search Bobby approved or Flav City. Download the Flav City app. It works by scanning anything at the grocery store, scan the barcode. It tells you if it's Bobby approved or not. Why? It'll highlight the bad ingredients and give you a better alternative. It's like having me shop with you. We've only done a soft launch. I haven't talked about it that much. We have a bunch of users, so please check it out. You're gonna love it. Right next to it, these are great. Talking about loving it, Hugh, the guys who make the gems, the chocolate chips I love, they have these new paleo cookies. They're a little pricey, $4.99 for a small bag, but these guys do it right. Look at this, coconut oil, cocoa butter, wow, cashew flour, all legit ingredients. Everything Hugh does is fantastic. Just a little pricey maybe, but really, really tasty. Oh, what else we got here? I've been talking about it so much. Two of the three Siete cookies are sold out. These are grain-free paleo Mexican chocolate cookies. I love the packaging, they did a great job. Another company out of Austin, Texas. Everything cool food-wise is coming out of Austin, Texas lately. Look at this. I mean, cooked in coconut oil, avocado oil, jasmine tea extract at the end there, classy. These are so good. Try those for sure. I wish those would come to Costco. That'd be amazing. And Emmy's. Emmy's has a new thing here. Most all Emmy's are Bobby approved. Thin and crispy peanut butter brownie snaps with peanut butter chocolate chips. Now, what are the chocolate chips made of? Well, first of all, it's made of brown rice flour and peanut flour, which is a nice base for a cookie. But look, the peanut butter chips are actually made with peanut flour, cocoa butter, and coconut sugar. I've never seen clean ingredients like that. Touch of cane sugar in the chocolate chips, coconut oil, real deal ingredients. That is super clean, whereas people look to this. This is a popular keto snack, not something I would get because all of these use the palm oil in here. But I also use natural flavors here. You want to avoid palm oil. There's a very big difference between clean keto, clean paleo, and dirty paleo, dirty keto. Dirty keto, in my opinion, uses palm oil and other oils that are highly processed, highly refined, highly inflammatory, and highly free radical laden. So avoid the palm oils. Swap it out with the better options like the coconut oils, the avocado oils. But just in this one section alone, talk about healthy junk food. Woo, get that. Get a show on Netflix. You're good to go. If you haven't had a chance to try the Laird Liquid Creamer, try it out. The flavor and texture is fantastic. But this week, they just launched for the season Pumpkin Spice Creamer. I feel like pumpkin spice season keeps getting pushed up every single year. And my friends, if you're a pumpkin spice fan, you have to try this creamer. I have an amazing promo code just for this week. This is legit because most pumpkin spice creamers will have horrific ingredients. You want to see amazing ingredients? Coconut milk based, coconut sugar, but just a touch, less than 1 gram per serving. Real pumpkin spices like cinnamon and nutmeg and ginger, actual pumpkin powder and virgin coconut oil. This morning I made a bulletproof pumpkin spice latte in my blender and had it with a breakfast, my keto breakfast. It was the breakfast of champions. Amazing. I have done whole videos about coffee creamers. Usually they're made with hydrogenated oils, tons of sugar, corn syrup, artificial flavors, natural flavors. They're horrific. Laird does it right. This stuff is fantastic. And if you're not a coconut fan, they now have the pumpkin spice in their oat and macadamia nut creamer. Use my link down below. The pumpkin spice is on sale up to 15% this week, but my code just for Flav City fans gets you another 10% off on top of that. Try this out. This is seriously one of the best coffee cream flavors I've ever had before. Use my link down below. Get the special promo code. You will love this stuff. Let me show you two of the most exciting clean players in the frozen pizza space. And number one is brand new. These guys, Bonza. Bonza is the guys who make that chickpea rice and chickpea pasta. They now have frozen pizza margarita or pizza crust. $8.99 is a little, that's interesting. It's $8.99 for two crust or $8.99 for one full pizza. So everything they do is chickpea based. This is actually really impressive. So look at the crust. It's chickpeas, which are nutrient dense, very high in fiber, very high in protein. Cocoa butter as the fat, olive oil as the oil, oregano, garlic. No cruddy oils, no natural flavors. That is legit. The topping, of course, is very minimal. It uses regular cheese. I've never found one that uses organic cheese, but still, it's pretty darn close to being perfect. I would probably get the crust and top it with my own organic mozzarella cheese. That's cool. And then I always, in the past, get this. I only buy it when it's on sale. This is the best paleo and gluten-free crust from Capello's. Look at these ingredients. Almond flour-based, cream it out with some coconut milk, extra virgin olive oil, not low carb because of the tapioca starch here. I buy it once it's on sale. This, make your own pizza, or bake it for 5 minutes and use it as a flatbread, and then dip it in some hummus or some lamb ragu or that. Very, very cool. I haven't tried the chickpea one. And then you gotta give it up to Amy. Amy's such an OG, been around forever. You know they've been offered to be bought out many times. They said no. I mean, you think of a burrito, normally junky ingredients, including a frozen one. So this is the Amy's Organic Black Bean Burrito. What's cool about this is not all Amy's ingredients are organic. This one's 100% organic. And my friends, when it comes to the first ingredient there, the organic unbleached wheat flour, very important. That's in the tortilla. Non-organic wheat can score high in glyphosate. What is glyphosate? It's the active ingredient in Roundup. So wheat and legumes and even oats can score high in glyphosate because it's so prevalent now. So you really want to get organic to minimize the glyphosate. And then every other ingredient here is organic, which is super, super impressive. The only thing I don't love is expeller pressed high oleic safflower or sunflower oil. Sometimes she'll use extra virgin olive oil. Expeller pressed is slightly better. High oleic refers to the fatty acid profile. It's slightly better, but still, in general, it's important to avoid those kind of processed oils and get the avocado oils, extra virgin olive oils, coconut oils. That being said, it's still the best of the burritos out there. That's the only one ingredient I don't love. Everything else is super clean. Amy's, including her soups and everything, OGs doing it right. Very impressive here in the frozen aisle. What if I told you there are some better for you options of chocolate milk? One dairy-based, one plant-based. Okay, actually amazing choices that I didn't have back in the 80s growing up. All we had was sugar-laden GMO milk. This right here, both refrigerated and shelf-stable. Maple Hill makes incredible 100% grass-fed milk. They also make butter too. But see what it says here about reduced sugar? That's really important because if you look at most chocolate milks, the amount of sugar, in my opinion, is type 2 diabetes inducing. When they say reduced sugar, they mean it. And one cup or 8 ounce serving only has 4 grams of added cane sugar. Do you see any nasty carrageenan and stuff like that? No. And it's grass-fed, which is the most nutrient-dense milk on the market. 4 grams is nothing. That's 1 teaspoon for a cup. Is it ideal? No. But when you compare it to the alternative of 8 to 15 to 20 grams I'll see in like other kind of Nesquakes or other kind of leading chocolate milks, this is big, big time Bobby approved for a chocolate milk, and it tastes great. Now, if you're dairy-free, like we are at home, come on yonder down here to this. This is a cool company. I don't know what happened to them. They used to have Peely Nut yogurt over there, and it's gone now. So I guess it wasn't selling well. But they have Sprouted Peely Nut chocolate milk here. It's dairy-free. It's sweetened with, I believe, dates. What does it say here? Yeah, a little bit of dates there. Look at that, Himalayan pink salt, a little bit of mesquite powder for smokiness. 0 grams of added sugar. Well, there actually technically is added sugar. I don't know why they do that. But 8 grams of total sugar, including the peely nuts, for 8 fluid ounces. The texture is fantastic. Rose goes gaga for this. I wait for it to go on sale, and that's a great option too. All right, Flav City family, that is it for Healthy Junk Food Part 2. If you haven't seen Part 1 the other week, check it out. Because if you know how to shop the grocery store, something I'm really good at and I love sharing with you guys, you can get the better for you, healthier junk food that you want to put in your body, not the stuff that has the cruddy ingredients. So that is it. Check out the Laird Pumpkin Spice Creamer using my promo link down below. You will love this stuff. It is gangbusters. If you have any other ideas for a video, leave a comment down below. Download the Bobby approved app, scan away at the grocery store. You're going to love it. But that is it from my happy place, the grocery store. I leave you like I always do. Hashtag keep on cooking. Mad love and peace. Later.